Well, Rhode Island is all about the people, places, and beauty we have here. And when a crisis takes place, it's a Rhodey's instinct to extend a helping hand. Washington Trust's I Love Rhode Island Facebook campaign is designed to celebrate and share everything that's special about the Ocean State. This month, we headed to Misquamicut Beach in Westerly, where just 5 months ago, Hurricane Sandy left her mark.
Hard to believe how far the town of Westerly's come since such a destructive hurricane.
We were so devastated here with Hurricane Sandy, and we wanted everyone to know that the beaches are back and the businesses along the beaches are back.
For Caswell Cook, who's lived here most of his life, Sandy hit home on many levels.
So I came down with the town manager and the governor and I think the director of DEM, and I just sort of got out in front of the Andrea Hotel, which is a place that I DJed for like 15 years, and it was just wrecked and, you know, 6 feet of sand in the street sort of thing. And I think I cried at first. I kind of had that reaction for a few minutes. When the top of a stop sign is kind of at your waist, you know, you kind of, and I looked around and I said, geez, I can really understand when people used to tell the stories about the 38 hurricane, like what happened. And I looked at Misquamicut and it was just flat.
But he stayed positive and immediately they started to clean up.
And everyone had to rebuild and everything had to be put back together. And so we did it. And now the beach is going to be better than you remember it.
And there was a lot of damage from the roofs and solar panels down to the electric and plumbing.
Yeah, Hurricane Sandy was a big one, and it affected a lot of our facilities, mostly the beaches. We have also a campground Burlingame that, you know, got a lot of tree damage, Goddard Park, a lot of tree damage as well. But mostly down here, Misquamicut, Scarborough, East Matunuck, we experienced a lot of damage that, you know, we've never had before.
Even the sand had to be cleaned.
Well, a lot of the sand went into the parking lots. We actually had 3 feet of sand, you know, level in our parking lots. It just blew right across the road. And what, you know, contractors did was they had to stockpile it all up and then sift the sand, just, you know, get the big particles out, any type of debris out of it, and then reapply the sand back onto the dunes and some to the beaches as well.
Caswell says now about 98% of the local businesses are back.
And the business that's right behind us, Two Little Fish, they were fortunate. They didn't have an ounce of water in the place, but directly across the street, this place called Sam's Snack Bar was wiped off the map. So for someone like Norm at Sam's Snack Bar, he has to rebuild his entire place.
But rest assured that the landmark places will be here.
Patty's and the Andrea and the Pleasant View, those places that tourists flock to, they're here. And the Andrea Hotel was the worst hit. They had to tear the building down, but they will be open this summer for a restaurant and bar and music and entertainment. And then they're going to build the hotel back in the fall.
They need our support more than ever now. And Washington Trust wants to help with a free beach pass when you open a new checking account.
We want people to get their beach passes, come down, help support the local businesses, attend the wonderful events we have down here at the beach, and really help the Ocean State economy get back and share everything we love about the state.
And Misquamicut Beach is just exit 1 off of 95. So on some beach days this summer, do something different and make Misquamicut a destination. Well, for a link to Washington Trust's I Love Rhode Island Facebook page, head to WPRI.com and click on the Roadshow.